Waking up to a weekday morning. It feels like maybe I have had less sleep, maybe a couple minutes more will do the job, but wish that was an option on a weekday. It's 7:30 a.m. better than those days when we used to rush to catch the school bus, so I'm happy about that. Self-care is a must for me in the mornings. I feel my biggest motivation comes from how I feel today. Like they say, if your bucket is not full, you have less to give to others too. So, what's the first thing one can do to feel ready and fresh for the day? That is to get rid of any sleepy yawns. And that gaze at the world outside does make a big difference in my prep me for the day. It's like those school days when I needed to be dragged out of bed. So now it's my turn to drag someone out. Kaya still needs help with her morning chores even after trying fancy toothbrushes and toothpastes. I guess mornings are difficult for everyone. But Kaya in her stage doesn't need motivation to run through her day. She is happy to be up once her sleep is over and doesn't have a checklist to follow throughout the day. Things that keep you motivated every morning. This is one discovery I'm on. I guess when you don't have a to-do list to go through in a day, and when you ensure that you don't need to check all the boxes, you're better motivated for handling the day. But that's just my thought. For some, it's motivating to see what they accomplished in the day. A small thing like tidying up my bedroom in the morning or emptying the dishwasher is a dose of motivation for me. It is a sign that a new day has begun. I don't want to overthink my breakfast, so when Kaya asked for French toast, there goes for her. I just add some veggies with it so she feels full before her class. I usually have this in my fridge. Grated carrots, corn and broccoli are a very few vegetables that she is fond of. But yes, a filling breakfast is a great motivator. I guess they are right. We all work for our belly, and when the belly is happy, we are happy. Indeed, good food is good mood. So today, it's masala dosa for breakfast for us, our favorite in the house. Since we moved to Bangalore and learned the art of making good dosas, there's no looking back. Kaya is not a big fan of dosa. I don't know why, never tried to really judge her on that. I think we all have the right to preference. What do you think? While I prepare the dosas, my thoughts run wild. Will I be able to complete shoot and edits for the week? Will Kaya be okay with the lunch today? What should I cook so that Kaya clears her plate? And then I realize that I'm just stressing myself about things that I can't control. There are a lot of things that you don't like but you can't change. So it's better I focus my energy on things that are in my control. The breakfast, for instance, that's what I'm on. Why worry about what will happen at lunch? Little girls love to get their hair styled. I'm sure anyone with a girl child would be able to relate to this. Kaya loves her long hair, though it's becoming a little difficult to manage it these days due to the tangles and her resistance to untangle it. So the online classes are a boon since it makes sure we don't miss out on education during this difficult time. Also, there is so much time with family. There is so much to do in the extra time, but we sometimes don't even notice it. And sometimes too much of everyone's presence in the house could be overwhelming and lead to fights, if you know what I mean. And there are so many dishes to be done during the day that you realize the importance of the dishwasher. How did I live without it before I got one? However, there are many utensils which are not dishwasher safe, so it needs that extra care to make it last longer. So I would need to give them a hand wash. But yes, dishwasher does save me a lot of effort. In one of my previous video, couple of months ago, I had spoken to you all about the primary math learning app which Kaya has been using. Matific has now become one of her favorite apps to keep her busy productively after her school online classes. I have also noticed that over the months, it has helped her understand the fundamentals of maths and it has now become one of her favorite subjects. In case you have missed the video, I will link it up in the info tab. So, a little more about Matific. Matific is an award-winning digital maths resource loved by millions of students from around the world. They are, in fact, the fastest growing maths e-learning platform in Australia and across the world. This is one digital resource which assures me that Kaya is getting quality screen time when she is on it and at the same time allows me to finish the morning chores. Their game-based activities are mapped to math curriculum for grades K to 6. I really enjoy watching Kaya explore new maths concepts, solve challenges and have fun at the same time. Matific recently launched their premium version in India and they reached out to us to try out some of their new features, which includes a parents dashboard which helps me keep a track on her progress on the Matific curriculum. With this premium version, we were able to avail an unlimited access to all their course material for Kaya. One of Part's favorite feature is the access to the parents dashboard so he can monitor learning gaps and make his own learning plan for her. At the end of the week, it's a great way to get a comprehensive view of what Kaya has learned, what her strengths are, and where she needs some help. Best part is that one can get a 7-day free trial before you opt to subscribe to it. You can cancel anytime during the free trial. No strings attached. Also, Matific has been kind enough to offer special discount for my followers. You can use the coupon code DIAINFIN25 to get 25% off when you sign up for your child for Matific. I would urge you to give Matific app a try. I'm sure your kid would love it, just like Kaya. This is an experiment, carrot and apple juice. Kaya is really fond of carrots, hence I decided to try it out. Her ask for carrot juice really motivated me to try some. But I realized that there's a lot of food waste generated when you want to make carrot or apple juice.
Try this and see if you like it or make you more, okay?
And it's better to eat this just like that, as I felt really bad looking at what my juice extracted collected as residue. Though I have used the vegetable extract creatively in some recipes, which I may show you in some upcoming videos. Moral of the story is, it isn't a good idea to make carrot or apple juice because of the meager amount of juice extract it produces, unlike an orange, which is super juicy. And it's equally important for kids to go out, get some vitamin D, that kind of keeps them going. So that 1 hour trip to the children's play area is a must after her classes. There are a lot of days though when she would miss it and would be cranky all afternoon. She goes to the park downstairs, which is visible from our house balcony. Hence, I'm not worried about her being there without me. Time to prepare lunch, and my worries from the morning had an option I could prepare. I will try a paneer butter masala, less spice, more buttery and sweet. Hope it turns out well. The queen of the dish is the paneer itself. The paneer I'm using is homemade malai paneer by a local vendor. He's the one who always delivers my paneer. And trust me, this dish tastes best with his paneer. It's a common misconception that a housewife's life is very uninteresting. People believe that some of us are cooking and cleaning out of no choice. But it's not true. My happiness today isn't cooking in this new pot. For the hour, it helps me forget any other unhappiness that I might be going through. And I'm doing it in a new colorful cast iron pot. That's my present happiness. I'm not sure if you understand my feeling. All I want to say is that I'm focused on what makes me happy for the moment. Parth loves rotis. I think we will have a bit of jeera rice and roti today, a complete North Indian menu. Me as a person have very few asks to keep my morale high. One of the high priority one is to have my kitchen clean. So I take up the task while Kaya is at the park. Though my house help already did the sweeping and mopping of the house, I would still do a basic cleaning of the kitchen and dining area, which tends to be messy the most after I'm done cooking lunch. And by the time she's back, I would be halfway through folding and arranging my laundry. The one thing I defer until 2 baskets are full. So yes, today is the day to get them off my to-do list. I intentionally let my clean laundry collect and do it all at once so that I don't feel like I'm doing laundry every day, if that makes sense, or this is just the way I console myself. If you guys know me, you already know how much I despise keeping laundry in their respective places. It feels good to have clothes kept where they belong and not having to hunt for it in the laundry baskets when you need them. It means you are ready for your next move.
Barbie is all ready to go to a party with Ken.
Handsome is handsome.
What does that mean? What does that mean?
Look at her hair, guys. Doesn't it look so beautiful and rainbow?
Conveniences of India include a press wala in our basement, so I'm keeping these clothes aside for iron. Clothes and laundry at my home never seem to end, but that means I have things to do and defer from time to time. For me, motivation comes from my daily activities and from not thinking reaching any goals. My happiness in completing my daily responsibilities is my contentment. I try to live in the moment and enjoy the little things in life. Another very important habit for being positive during tough times is to take life as it comes, instead of rushing to make things perfect. There are also days when I feel low and end up doing nothing, but I don't regret those days. I make sure that I'm charged up for the next one and take the day as it comes. What's your motivation for the day? Feel free to comment down below and let me know. Thanks for watching today's one. I'll see you soon. Bye.